Today we're going to go over the distance sensor in the Spike Prime kit. You can use the sensor to measure the distance to an object or a surface anywhere between 5 centimeters and 200 centimeters, though it can get a little less accurate the farther away you get. We'll be going over a couple different commands you can use to program the sensor in both word blocks and Python coding, and you can use the timestamps to go to the part of the video that you need.
Let's go ahead and get started.
First off, we're going to start with the blocks coding. If you notice at the top, we have a little icon that looks like a pair of robotic eyes, and the number on the bottom tells you the distance that the sensor is currently measuring. Let's start off by clicking the events bubble and finding the starting block with the distance sensor icon on it. We'll drag that and drop it down, and we can change a few of the parameters. My sensor is in port A, you can change yours to wherever you are. And you have the option to choose between closer than, farther than, or exactly at for the distance that your sensor needs to measure in order to start running the program. I'm going to choose closer than, I'm going to choose 10, and you can choose between percentage of the max, which is 200 centimeters. You can use centimeters or just inches. I'm going to use centimeters because I believe in metric. I'm also going to grab a motor. Mine is in port F automatically. Gonna have it run clockwise, this time for 3 rotations. Then we can come down and start the program. And when we test it, you'll notice that the icon will start decreasing in number as we get closer and closer. And once we pass that 10 centimeter threshold, your motor will start spinning. And if you want it to run again, all you need to do is pass that threshold, come back, and then it goes. Let's get more interesting though. I'm going to remove the motor, get rid of this start block, and instead, I'm going to go into events and grab a regular when program starts block. I'm also going to go into the controls bubble and grab the repeat until block, the one that's right here. We're going to attach it, and you'll notice that it has a little rhombus shape. And when you go into the sensors bubble, you'll notice that for the distance sensor, you have 2 different kinds of blocks. You have one that's sharp edges, kind of like the rhombus, and you have one that's smooth. And what's important to remember when it comes to sensors is that we can use the values they measure to act as inputs on our code, and our code can react based on what those inputs are. So if we grab this block and drop it into the rhombus on this repeat until block, what we're basically saying is when this program starts, whatever we put in here is going to keep happening until this condition from the sensor is met. And if I grab the motor block and drop it in here, exact same thing, clockwise for 3 rotations, but change the parameters on the distance sensor, closer than, and still 10 centimeters. And what's going to happen when we rerun it is that until we get within 10 centimeters, the motor will just keep running and running and running and stop once we're at those 10 below those 10 centimeters. And you can see this being important when you have something like a car, when you want to avoid it crashing into anything. First, make sure you have a script open and that distance sensor is being imported from Spike. It does so by default, but just make sure. I'm also gonna go ahead and initialize a distance sensor, mine's in port A, and a regular motor, mine's in port F. Next, we'll open up the knowledge base and click into distance sensor, which is near the top. Focus on the events commands that are here for the sensor. And though the names are a little long, they're pretty straightforward. If we click into the closer than, you'll notice that the parameters are distance that you choose, we'll do 10 centimeters, the units, which can be in centimeters, inches, or percent value, and short range, which we're gonna ignore, but you can read a little bit more about here if you want. If we go to the bottom, I'm just going to copy the example code that they have exactly and drop it into my script. The units are what I want, which is in centimeters, but I want it to be 10 centimeters instead of 20. And then at the bottom, we can just write motor.start. And now we have a simple code that says when the distance sensor measures that something's closer than 10 centimeters, start the motor. And when we run this, you'll notice that we get closer and closer, but that nothing happens until we pass those 10 centimeters. This program works well when you want to set a starting condition based on the value the distance sensor is reading. But one problem you might notice is that the motor just won't stop even when there's nothing in front of the sensor after it starts. Once it passes this, it'll just keep going and going and going. So I'm going to walk you through one way to write a simple loop that will stop the motor when you're too close to an object, but restart it when it's far enough away. And you can see this being useful for something like a car or a vehicle, so it stops right before crashing into something. You'll also be able to copy this code that we're gonna write directly from the description underneath the video. Let's get rid of these 2 lines of code, but I'm still going to keep my distance sensor, and my motor, and we're going to make a while loop that will keep running while true. We set it up this way, it'll essentially run until we stop it. Next, we're going to copy and paste another distance sensor command from the knowledge base, this time get distance in centimeters. And these three commands right here just measure whatever the value is that the distance sensor is currently reading. And you don't even need to worry about the parameter because all we're doing with this command is taking whatever value the distance sensor is currently reading, and we can just copy directly from the example down here. That, paste, and here it says wall detector, but mine is distance sensor, so I'm going to replace that. And we're going to make sure that it's outside of our if statements so that it updates with each iteration of the loop. And we want to say in the if statement is if the distance in centimeters is greater than or equal to 10 centimeters, then we just want the motor to start. And other than that, meaning that the distance is less than 10 centimeters, then we just want the motor to stop. But there is one big caveat that's hard to tell the first time you use the distance sensor. If you notice on the sensor icon, it's currently reading 200 centimeters, but that's not quite right. The sensor is only able to read to 200 centimeters, even if in reality it was 10,000. And when the sensor hits that limit of 200 centimeters, it actually prints out the value none. So what we need to do is add in an elif statement to account for this. And then in if, I'm going to say if distance in centimeters is equal to none, then I still want the motor to go, because that's still greater than our 10 centimeter threshold. And the reason I put the distance in centimeter in elif rather than an if is because the code gets a little bit fidgety at times and doesn't like it when the equal to none condition is in the elif statement. So this should work. And if we run it, it won't work because the none needs to be capitalized. So we run it again. The motor will keep running until that threshold of 10 centimeters is reached. It stops, and when it's away, it'll start again, and then it'll start again, etc., etc. And there you go. Now you have a code that you can use in these different projects to start and stop based on what the distance sensor is measuring. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you learned something in this tutorial. Please remember to like the video, and if you want to learn more about the spike prime, make sure to check out our other tutorials.